Hello students, today I will give revision of class 7 subject chemistry, revision of chapter 2 physical and chemical changes. Let us see tables on page number 14, 15 and 23, activities on page number 16, 18 and 20. Page number 14, two tables are given, table 2.1 and table 2.2. Table 2.1 shows differences between desirable and undesirable changes. Table 2.2 shows the differences between reversible and irreversible changes. Now come to page number 15. Page number 15, table 2.3. Differences between exothermic and endothermic changes. This table you have to focus on. Then page number 16, activity is given. Activity 2.1. Aim, to show that dissolution of salt is a physical change. This activity. Then come to page number 18. Page number 18, activity 2.2. Aim, to show that sublimation of ammonium chloride is a physical process. This activity continues to page number 19 also. Then page number 20, activity 2.4, aim, to understand that curdling of milk is a chemical change. Then come to page number 23, table 2.4, differences between physical and chemical changes. This table you have to focus on. Then come to question answer. Question answer, page number 27. Short and precise, A number. Show the given text in the form of flowcharts. Types of changes and question number 2. Classification of various physical and chemical changes. Then B number, give reasons for the following statements. Question number 1. Curdling of milk is an irreversible change. Question number 2. Cooking of food is an endothermic change. Question number 3. Baking a chapati is a chemical change. Question number 4. Dissolving is a physical change. Question number 5. The process of freezing can easily be reversed. And question number 6. The rate of evaporation decreases with increase in humidity. So in question number B, give reason, all are for revision work. Come to page number 28. C, answer in short. Question number 3. What happens to the chemical composition of original substance during a chemical change? Question number 4. How will you come to know that a chemical change has occurred? Question number 5. What is the importance of chemical changes? Question number 6. Why is melting considered a physical change? Then, at length, A number, differentiate between the following. 3 number, exothermic changes and endothermic changes. Question number 4, physical changes and chemical changes. Then come to C number, answer in detail. Question number 1, what are chemical changes? With the help of an activity, explain that curdling of milk is a chemical change. Question number 2, list the characteristics of physical and chemical changes. Question number 4, with the help of an activity, show that heat energy is released during a chemical change. Question number 5, differentiate between boiling and evaporation. Explain the factors affecting evaporation. And question number 6, with the help of an activity, explain the process of sublimation. So, you focus on these questions for revision, which I have just now said. The revision of chapter 3 will not be given because in chapter 3 there is only one topic in the half yearly syllabus. So you practice the questions of chapter 3 only which are related to the topic. Thank you.